Hi and welcome back to PR Tech Talk. And to this short video on how to get started with the QCC744M module. If you bought this development board and you would like to see how to get started with it, then this is the right video for you. But if you take a start guide or something like that and you take a look on the pinnings, first of all, is the G3 header and this is the G4. This is how the jumpers are settings on the default, and that is correct. You don't need to change anything there. But on the G3, you can see another picture. So you see that there are jumpers on all positions here. But on the board, there is only delivered with these two pins, and that is quite okay. You don't need the others. It will work like this. What the others are, these are for JTAG, and we won't use JTAG. And this is for the UART RX and TX, and that is for the UART DTR and RTS, and we don't use that either. So that is quite fine to just use those. It's okay. So if we take a look on the block diagram, it looks like this, that we have two USB-C connectors. The one is G1, and the other one is G9. So this one is going to the USB port on the module itself, the G9, and we also have the G1, that is the one that we are using. And that then hosts power to the module, and it also goes down to this USB bridge, which then take care of these two pins that we are looking for. That says four pins for the UART, but we only use two pins. And there is also this JTAG connector. And if we take on the look on the schematics itself, we can see here that here we have the G3. And that is the 11 to 12 and the 13 to 14 that are default. And that is the TX and RX. So those two pins are needed to be communicating with the module. The rest is for the JTAG. And then we have also the CTS and RTS there. And then there is not much happening. We have the USB to the UART interface. We have the JTAG, which is not in play at this moment then. And we also have two buttons, the S1 for boot and the reset, that is the S2. To debug it, you need to have a UART terminal program, and I'm using PuTTY. And there is something special with this that you need to take care of. And that is the terminal port. Now, let's see if I can see it here. Ah, so there it is. The baud rate. The baud rate is not very common. So it's a 2 megabit baud rate. So you can't use 115.200. You need to write 2 megabit there instead. Apply. When you have done that, you can just press reset on the board and you will have a lot of boot data coming out of the module. And you can just then hit enter to see the terminal program, and we can write help here to see all the commands that we can use. And for demonstration purpose, I have created a new Wi-Fi access point in my network here. And so I will just write Wi-Fi station connect, and then I have my SSID, and then I have my new password, and this one is in clear text as I write it here. This is a clear security breach. You don't put out your password in YouTube videos, but this YouTube or this Wi-Fi will be killed before this one goes live. It's no problem there. Now we see that we got an IP here. We got an IP from my DHCP server. So it's 192.168.0.7D. And I have the mask and I have the gateway here as well. And we can then go further on writing Wi-Fi status station info. There we have the IP number as well. This was just a short video how to get started with the module, and then there is an SDK that Qualcomm also provide for you, and I will do that in a coming video, setting up Visual Studio Code and installing the software development kit so you can download new software and program into this module. Hope you liked it, and if you did, give it a thumbs up. It doesn't cost you anything, but it's highly appreciated from my side. And if you're not a subscriber, please consider to do so. It's also free of charge. And if you have some comments to give me, just use the comments below. See you in the next video. Stay safe. Bye.